Welcome to Mongoose channel. Sometimes people ask this question, what is the minimal microcontroller requirement to run Mongoose? Let's find out. Go to Mongoose GitHub repository, navigate to examples Arduino. There are several examples. W5500 HTTP implements a minimal web server using W5500 Ethernet module. W5500 MQTT implements a minimal MQTT client. We will talk about Ethernet and W5500 in another video, but for now, let's just open HTTP example in the Arduino IDE. Select a classic Arduino Uno, which has 2K of RAM and 32K of flash. Click on Compile. It fails. Okay, we need a bit more flash and RAM. Select Arduino Nano Avery, which is an 8-bit ATmega 4809 with 6K of RAM and 48K of flash. Click Compile. It works. Time to test it. Here is an Arduino Nano Avery wired to the W5500 module. Power and ground, SPI clock, TX and RX. W5500 provides a built-in socket API, but Mongoose does not use it. It uses W5500 to send and receive raw Ethernet frames and implements the whole TCP/IP stack in software. We are using an external LED connected to pin 21 because the built-in nano LED shares a pin with SPI, so we cannot use it. I've connected an LED without a current limiting resistor. Don't do that. Let's take a closer look at the sketch. Pins are correct. This structure is used by Mongoose to talk SPI. MG millis tell Mongoose the current time. MG random is used by TLS. We will not need it for now. Get free RAM is a simple function that calculates free memory. In the setup, we initialize serial for logs, initialize SPI, initialize Mongoose event manager, set debug log level, redirect logs to serial, initialize W5500 built-in driver, and initialize TCP/IP stack. MG HTTP listen call initializes HTTP listener on port 80. For every HTTP request, we check the requested URL. API LED on requests would turn on the LED. API LED off requests would turn off the LED. And all other requests will show the free RAM. Flash the sketch. Copy IP address, open it in the browser. Now turn on the LED. And turn it off. And show the free memory. So, since the board has 6K of RAM, we have about 1K free. Considering we need some stack space too, we can conclude that this is about the bottom limit. So, 8-bit microcontroller, 6K of RAM, and 48K of flash. Let's try MQTT example 2. It is very similar to HTTP in terms of setup, but instead of running a local web server, it connects to the remote MQTT server. It subscribes to the MGRX topic and reacts on the on and off MQTT messages. Let's flash it. Connect to the HiveMQ broker. Subscribe to MG/hash topic. Send on message to MGRX topic. LED is on. Send off message. LED is off. As we can see, MQTT is slightly less hungry for RAM. The next question is, how about TLS? What's the minimum footprint required to run HTTPS server and connect to MQTTS? The answer to that is in the next video. As always, thanks for watching.